Bremen High School seniors, it is Kaylin Allen from the Ellen DeGeneres Show, and I'm just here to say congratulations. You have done it, and I know this has been done in the most unconventional way. However, you still did it, and that is what matters, and I just want to know that I just want you to know that I am so very proud of you. I truly am, and I hope that you go on and do amazing and big things. Never stop dreaming. Never give up on yourself, and continue to be persistent and resilient no matter what. I love you. Congratulations.
When you take that jump, you don't fear the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall.
Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay.
That you fall in love and it hurts so bad. The only way you can know is give it all you have.
And hope that you don't suffer but take the pain. Hope when the moment comes you'll say
quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter. shudder 'cause you're dreaming. So I tuck you in, turn on your favorite nightlight. To you, everything's funny. You got nothing to regret. I'd give all I have, honey, if you could stay like that. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple. I won't let nobody hurt you. Won't let no one break your heart. No, no one will desert you. Just try to never grow up. Never grow up.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble, it might drag you down. You get lost, you can always be found. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Didn't see no use in sticking around. I was green and busting at the seams to leave. I was sitting on G, waiting on O. The day I hit 18, I hit the road, traded that county maintained for a four-lane city street. But sometimes things ain't what you think they're gonna be. What you want ain't always what you need. Don't know what you got till it's gone and you're out on your own. All you want is what you can't get back. Once you let it go, then you know what you have. Don't hold a candle to what you have. Sometimes what you think you'll find, it ain't quite what real life has in store. So be careful what you wish for. We wanted 5 more minutes.
Knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. Always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. And it's so hard.
So glad I got to know you. that can hold us. Ain't no hate that can fold us. Put on the chains and we'll break them. They want a battle, we'll take them. Flow like a butterfly, sting like a bee. They can't keep us on a leash. The kings of our little towns, if there's a rebel around, you know it's gonna be one of us. We're right at home in the wild, can't help it, that's our style. Born and bred to be dangerous. We might roll on a Saturday night, get that look in our eyes, and we're striking like lightning. Some may say we're too loud, some may say we're too proud. Well, there's lambs and there's lions. Our heads are down with our eyes up, just like the sun, yeah, we'll rise up. Better think twice for your size up. Your second thought, yeah, you're wiser. Towns, if there's a rebel around, you know it's gonna be one of us. We're right at home in the wild, can't help it, that's our style. Born and bred to be dangerous. We might roll on a Saturday night, get that look in our eyes, and we're striking like lightning. Some may say we're too loud, some may say we're too proud. Well, there's lambs and there's lions. We are lions, we are lions, we are lions, we are lions.
the help of an awful lot of folks, and especially our sponsors today, Bremen School Corporation, the entire staff and administration at Bremen Schools. We'd like to wish this year's senior class of 2020 the best of luck in their future. Thanks for your hard work and dedication to us and your community. Bremen Schools, empowering our students academically and socially to succeed in life. And our good friends from Digger Specialties Incorporated in Bremen. Proud to support the graduating class of 2020. Supporting the Bremen community since 1984. We go the extra mile to provide customers with the best in virtually maintenance-free fencing and building products available. Congratulations, Bremen, class of 2020. All right, we're about a minute away from getting things started here with Mr. Jennings. So here's some graduation music leading up to 2 o'clock, which is just about a minute away.
Welcome to the 130th commencement ceremony at Bremen High School. My name is Bruce Jennings. I am the principal of Bremen High School. As we begin this historic event, I would like to invite senior Shauna York to the stage by singing the national anthem of our great nation, the United States of America.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free and the
thank you, Shauna. What a fantastic day it is. It's a day to create some special memories, a day to honor our seniors, a day to appreciate life, maybe even a day to feel a little bit blessed to be at the epicenter of the legendary Bremen bubble. Though this graduating class is one of the smallest classes in recent years, with less than 100 students. Walking across this stage today, less than 100 students, but they are certainly leaving a positive legacy and regarding how they've handled adversity and weathered a major storm of life. Seniors, I encourage you to find ways to enjoy each other today while maintaining the new buzzword, a little social distancing. We know that you've missed each other. Please know that the staff members of Bremen High School have certainly missed you. I'd like to briefly share some facts about the class of 2020, so please indulge me just for a moment. 81% of the seniors are planning to continue their education beyond high school at 25 different colleges, universities, or trade schools in 6 different states. And 48 seniors are sharing over $110,000 in local scholarship money from our supportive Bremen community. 5 seniors have enlisted in the military, and they will be leaving soon for boot camp. So I'm very thankful that they could experience this today. However, 7 of our foreign exchange students, and we've never had 7 exchange students, usually it's less than 5, all 7 have already left for their home countries. Marie, Maya, Lilia, representing Germany, Sinja from Austria, Rodrigo from Spain, and Jose from Honduras. I wish they could be with us today. Maybe they are on social media. Hopefully they'll be able to return to us and visit soon. I am so grateful for today's beautiful weather. It's perfect. I'm also grateful for the collaborative effort necessary to make this unique commencement ceremony happen. Most importantly, I'm extremely grateful for the strong leadership of the class of 2020. They made this happen today, and I'm so proud of them. Therefore, it's only fitting that the class president be the first speaker, be the first to receive the diploma, and address her classmates first. Please welcome to the podium Guadalupe Lupita Torres, the daughter of Sylvia and Carlos Torres.
Thank you, Mr. Jennings, and thank you to everyone involved in making this day possible for the class of 2020. We are truly extremely grateful. I think it's fair to say that all of us today were expecting a very traditional ceremony, one where Mr. Jennings spoke for a little too long and we waited and sat in our chairs forever. While yes, we are not getting this ideal picture-perfect finale, I think we're getting something a little bit better. Today, we are leaving our mark on the town of Bremen. The class of 2020 will go down as one of, if not the most unique graduation ceremonies to ever take place here at Bremen High School. We will be known as the class that, through all things that life had to throw at us, we came out stronger. With everything going around in our world today, it is comforting to know that our town can come together to make it a day to celebrate the seniors. As a class, we have faced more obstacles than we can count, and we've lost things near to our hearts, but I'd like to believe it made us stronger. So together, let's take this final step as the dedicated and resilient class that I know we are. Thank you.
Thank you, Lupita. In addition to being the president of the class of 2020, Lupita is also the president of the Awaken Compassionate Teens Club of Bremen High School, a club that does service projects to help local children and children in other countries. As she receives her diploma from Dr. White, I want to note that Lupita is planning to attend Indiana University in South Bend to major in human resource management, to become a professional in building positive relationships, and it appears that she's already mastered that. Congratulations, Lupita Torres. It was a sad day for a lot of our seniors when the spring musical had to be canceled. The musical cast and crew and the members of the Pip Band had already put in a lot of work preparing for a performance that was less than 2 weeks away when school was canceled on March 13th. I'm so proud of the many seniors, the talented seniors that we have who excelled in art and music. And I wish I had time to give all of them a shout out. However, I would like to note that the valedictorian of the class of 2020 has been instrumental, literally, in the concert band, pip band, pep band, and jazz band of Bremen High School. It is with great pleasure and congratulations that I present to you the valedictorian of the class of 2020, the son of Amy and Nevin Miller, Chandler J. Miller.
As most of you know, many of my fellow seniors especially, I came to Bremen in fifth grade. Now, at the time, that was a very scary and very anxious time for me, especially since I had never been to a public school before and I didn't know what to expect. However, when I look back at that time, it doesn't really seem like that big of a deal or that I should have been scared. In the same way, there are many things that each one of us have done or gone through in the past that seem insignificant or fleeting when we look back. However, sometimes the things that we have done in the past leave more of an impact on both ourselves and others than we may even realize. When it comes to talking about things in the past, most people will tell you to just leave it in the past. What has happened is happened. Just let it go. But I think that it is important to remember our pasts. In my opinion, the better phrase would be to not dwell in the past. Think of it this way. Why do we have history classes? Well, the reason for history classes is so that we can learn from the past and not repeat the mistakes that have been made. And to be honest, most of us don't think about our history classes outside of school, so in the same way, we shouldn't dwell on the past and what has happened to us in the past. Throughout my 8 years at Bremen, I have made many memories. Some of them have been really amazing, and I'm really thankful for them, and others have been not so great, but either way, I'm still thankful for all the many memories that I have. I'm thankful for the many friends that I've made and all the memories we have had together. I'm thankful for the many teachers, coaches, administrators, and other faculty that have been there for me and have pushed me to become who I am today. I am thankful for my family that has always been there to support me throughout the years of schooling that I've been through. And finally, I am thankful for this wonderful community that has always been there since day one for us seniors and supported us in everything that we've done. As we leave this chapter in our lives and go on to the next one, there are a couple things that I want us to remember. First of all, remember that your past doesn't define you, but it does shape you into who you are today. And secondly, remember your past and where you came from, so that that way you can appreciate today and always strive for a better future. Thank you.
Just to put around your neck.
Thank you, Chandler. In addition to being the class valedictorian, Chandler is also the vice president of his class. He enjoys being a member of the baseball team also. Sorry about baseball season this year, Chandler. Chandler plans to attend Purdue University to major in electrical engineering. Boiler up, Chandler. Not only are there talented artists in the class of 2020, there are some pretty good athletes too. My heart still aches for the seniors who lost their whole spring sports season. I think we canceled about 250 events this spring. 29 seniors have received recognition by the Northern Indiana Conference for their outstanding athletic and/or academic performance. 5 seniors are 3-sport athletes. 5 seniors will be added to the Athletic Wall of Fame. 5 seniors plan to play a sport at the collegiate level. One of those 3-sport athletes being added to the Wall of Fame is also number 2 academically in the class of 2020. It is with great pleasure and pride I present to you the salutatorian of the class of 2020, the daughter of Gina Hall, Rachel Lee Hall.
Good afternoon. Over the past few months, I've been thinking about what I wanted to say as my final words to my classmates, and not being able to see you all for the past few months has not made that any easier. About this time, 3 years ago, we were finishing our freshman year, thinking to ourselves, and we still have 3 more to go? Now, here we are, ready to receive our diplomas, ready to escape into the real adult world that we may not feel ready for, but Bremen High School has prepared us for. Just as high school has passed, we can see that this pandemic that we are experiencing too is passing and hopefully soon coming to an end. This goes to show that even the most terrible and unfathomable things shall pass with our time. Of course, that's not to say high school is terrible or unfathomable. At least, I hope not for most of us. I hope you are all able to remember this. All of the awful and wonderful experiences we encounter in our future will not last forever. When you are inevitably experiencing the bad, have patience, take a breath, and know it will all run its course. It will not last forever, and you will see the other side. And of course, when life is going just the way you want it, don't forget to appreciate it, and don't overlook all that you overcame to achieve it. As we all sit in our cars today, let's take a moment to appreciate how much we've grown, how hard we've worked, and how far we have yet to go. And finally, I want to remind you that the hard work, kindness, and patience that you've all exhibited in these past few years are the exact same attributes that will take you very far into our lives. We all have amazing futures ahead of us, and I have confidence in all of your abilities to work hard and achieve all of it that you each desire in life. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2020.
Thank you, Rachel. In addition to being an outstanding endurance athlete in cross-country, swimming, and track, Rachel is the president of the Key Club and the B Club at Bremen High School. She was selected to receive the Mary Margaret Trice and Fritz Nierste Academic Athlete Award, and she plans to pursue a career in dentistry by attending Indiana University in South Bend. Congratulations, Rachel. Okay, the pace is about to pick up. Dr. White, Mr. Rohde, are you ready? As each graduate is called across the stage to receive their diploma, the next graduate should be waiting at the top of the steps for their name to be called. Please avoid beeping the car horns until the final graduate receives his diploma from Mr. Rohde and Dr. White. And Dr. White will then declare all the graduates that they can move their tassels from right to left side and become graduates, members of the long green line of Bremen. First up, Rebecca Castro, daughter of Zaneta and Jose Castro, a top 10 senior academically and an academic outstanding artist. Rebecca plans to attend Indiana University in South Bend to study general architecture. Rebecca Castro. Erin Koffel, daughter of Melissa and Robert Koffel, a top 10 senior academically and selected as the most outstanding female athlete at Bremen High School. Erin was also selected as the softball player of the year, the best softball player for two consecutive years in the entire state of Indiana. When Erin was a freshman, she committed to play softball at the University of Kentucky, where she will study kinesiology. Erin Koffel. As soon as Riley gets done doing a selfie with Mrs. Reed, we'll get her up on stage. Riley Gilmer, daughter of Sarah and Matt Gilmer, a top 10 senior academically. Riley is also Bremen's Distinguished Young Woman of 2020. Riley has been involved in drama productions, musicals, and the development of the school yearbook. She plans to attend Ball State University to major in telecommunications and theater. Riley Gilmer. Jennifer Gonzalez, daughter of Consuelo and Jose Gonzalez, a top 10 senior academically and the outstanding dual credit government and finite math student at Bremen High School. Jennifer has chosen to attend Indiana University at South Bend to major in human resource management. Jennifer Gonzalez. Jasmine Graham, daughter of Melinda and Larry Graham, a top 10 senior academically. Jasmine is the president of the National Honor Society chapter at Bremen High School, vice president of the student council, secretary of the senior class. She has decided to attend Purdue University to have a double major in dietetics and nutrition. and fitness and health, Jasmine Graham. Samuel Huffman, son of Melissa and Jason Huffman, and Cammie Huffman and Don Combus. A top 10 senior academically, Sam is the most outstanding male athlete in the senior class. He was named as the outstanding earth science student in addition to being the MVP of the football team. Sam is committed to play football at Manchester University, where he will study to become an elementary school teacher, Samuel Huffman. Adam Jones, son of Jennifer Mokhtar and Doug Jones. A top 10 senior academically, Adam earned the athletic honors by receiving the United Soccer Coaches Association Senior Excellence Award. Adam will be pursuing a civil engineering degree at Purdue University. Adam Jones. Bailey Vermillion, daughter of Tracy Nisley and Jeremy Vermillion. A top 10 senior academically, Bailey has been a three-sport athlete at Bremen High School, while also earning the Work Ethic Award for her efforts in helping to produce the school yearbook. In fact, Bailey was also the one that put the senior class video together for today's commencement program. Bailey has already earned a training certificate at the Elkhart Career Center in nursing, and she is pursuing a career in medical imaging by attending Indiana University at South Bend. Bailey Vermillion. Jesse Aguayo, son of Maggie and Martin Aguayo. Jesse will be fine-tuning his welding skills by attending a trade school to become a professional welder or some type of welding mechanic. Jesse Aguayo. Jacob Andrews. Skylar Aukerman. Jacob Andrews, son of Lisa and Bill Andrews. Jacob plans to major in electrical engineering at Indiana Purdue University of Indianapolis. Jacob Andrews. Skylar Aukerman, son of Stephanie Martin and Billy Aukerman. Skylar enjoys automotive technology, and he plans to work for a year and then attend the University of Northwestern Ohio to pursue a career in auto mechanics. Skylar Aukerman. Brandon Balsley, son of Wanda and Jason Balsley. Brandon will be majoring in electrical engineering technology at Purdue University, Fort Wayne. Brandon Balsley. Jerick Balsley Mendoza, son of Deidre Balsley and grandson of Mary Balsley. Jerick was a four-year member of the Spell Bowl team, and he will be attending Ancilla College to pursue a degree in mechanical engineering. Jerick Balsley Mendoza. Luke Becker, son of Lori and Scott Becker. Luke has decided to attend Franklin College to participate on the swim team and major in business management with hopes of pursuing a career in the culinary arts. Luke Becker. Drew Brandel, son of Lisa Erickson and the late Jared Brandel. Drew enjoys politics, and he has decided to pursue a career in law by beginning his post-secondary studies at Vincennes University. He would like to eventually work in real estate as a mortgage broker. Drew Brandel. Taylor Britton, daughter of Jessica and David Britton. Taylor has decided to attend Indiana University in South Bend to pursue a career in either business, management, or nursing. Taylor Britton. Anders Brurock, son of Jennifer Brurock and Stole Brurock. Anders is the MVP of our swim team, will be entering the workforce while training to become a plumber or an electrician. Anders Brurock. Beck Brurock, son of Jennifer Brurock and Stole Brurock. Beck was a co-captain of the swim team and president of DECA. He was also an international qualifier in DECA competition, and he will be going to Indiana University in Bloomington to pursue a degree in entrepreneurship and corporate innovation. Beck Brurock. Brady Callantine, son of Julie Andreziak and Scott Callantine. Brady plans to pursue a career in the construction and welding industry or become a union pipe fitter. Brady Callantine. Stephanie Capes, daughter of Lucia and Stephen Capes. Stephanie has decided to attend Indiana University at South Bend, but she is currently undecided about a major area of study. Stephanie Capes. Victoria Cerrone, daughter of Wendy Cerrone and Dean Young. Victoria has been a participant in the color and winter guard throughout her high school career. She has decided to attend Maryville College to pursue a degree in finance and accounting with a goal of owning her own restaurant. Victoria Cerrone. Zachary Kraft, son of Heather and Mark Kraft. Zach was a three-sport athlete during his senior year at Bremen High School, and he will be attending Indiana University in South Bend with an interest in mechanical engineering and a possible enlistment in the Air Force. Zachary Kraft. David Delgado, son of Karen and Rudy Delgado. David has chosen to attend Ivy Tech in South Bend. However, he is undecided on a major at this time. David Delgado. Gabriel Dumpf, son of Allison Silver Raven and Brett Dumpf. Gabe is the president of the Bremen High School Science Club, and he will be pursuing a degree in computer science at the Purdue campus in Fort Wayne. Gabriel Dumpf. Deonira Dee Dee Duran, daughter of Consuelo and Ismael Duran. Dee Dee, a three-sport athlete, was selected as the United States Marine Corps Distinguished Female Athlete at Bremen High School. It's no surprise that Dee Dee will be pursuing a nursing degree at Indiana University of South Bend. Deonira Duran. Jewel Eganloff, daughter of Dawn and Joe Eganloff. After getting her diploma today, Jewel is leaving for California to work in a national park. Jewel Eganloff. Juan Esparza, son of Margarita and Sergio Abrahan. Juan hopes to be a law enforcement officer, and he will be attending Ivy Tech in South Bend to pursue a degree in criminal justice. Juan Esparza. Joanna Feitz, daughter of Gretchen and John Feitz. Next year, Joanna is going to be on the Fort Wayne campus of Purdue University to study civil engineering. Joanna Feitz. Ellie Feldman, daughter of Jody and John Feldman. Ellie is planning to pursue a career in social work by attending Ball State University. Ellie Feldman. Zachary Fernandez, son of Tina Hatfield and Jose Fernandez Rees. Zach is currently working in the retail business. However, he plans to start his own clothing design business very soon. He's also interested in marine biology. Zachary Fernandez. Cody Fritz, son of Tamara and Lee Fritz. Cody has been active in the school's drama and musical performances in addition to the production of the school newspaper. He is planning to live in Indianapolis to attend IUPUI and study biomedicine. Cody Fritz. Julio Gonzalez, son of Maria and Roberto Gonzalez. An all-conference soccer player at Bremen High School, Julio plans to attend Indiana University at South Bend to study exercise science in order to become a physical therapist. Julio Gonzalez. Jessica Grabowski, daughter of Debbie and Randy Grabowski. Jessica has been active in FFA and sports, and she will be pursuing a nursing degree at Indiana University in South Bend. Jessica Grabowski. Cassandra Graham, daughter of Melinda and Larry Graham. Cassie was the editor of the 2020 yearbook in addition to being on the swim team. She plans to become an elementary school teacher after attending college at Purdue University, Cassandra Graham. Quinn Haining, son of Kimberly Haining and Drew Granville. Quinn is planning to leave for California next week to enter the workforce where it's warm year-round. Quinn Haining. Brian Harden, son of Antonia Fernandez and Salvador Pena. Brian was the co-captain of the soccer team. He was the defensive MVP. He has worked various jobs throughout his high school career, and he plans to continue employment in the local workforce while attending Ivy Tech to study construction science. Brian Harden. Matthew Harmon, son of Jennifer and Tim Harmon. Matt has enjoyed being a percussionist in the band, and apparently he also likes bugs because he said he's planning to pursue a career in entomology. He will be starting his training at Ivy Tech and then transferring to Purdue University. Matthew Harmon. Logan Heller, son of Holly and Darren Heller. Logan has chosen to attend Ferris State University to pursue a career in architecture or construction management. Logan Heller. Kenneth Hilgendorf, son of Sharon and Kevin Hilgendorf. Kenny, a three-sport athlete and active participant in the arts at Bremen High School, he will be attending Lift Academy in Indianapolis or Western Michigan University to pursue a career in aviation. He wants to be an airline pilot. Kenneth Hilgendorf. Erin Hollett, daughter of Tina and Ted Hollett. Selected as the outstanding female choir student, Erin plans to pursue a career in social work by studying in South Bend at Indiana University. Erin Hollett. Samuel Holman, son of Jacqueline and David Holman. Sam served as the vice president of DECA, but he aspires to be the president of the United States. Sam has chosen Concordia University in Michigan to study justice and public policy. Samuel Holman. Luis Jacobo, son of Maribel and Juan Garcia. Luis was recently promoted in his current full-time retail job, and he plans to remain in the local workforce until his e-commerce stores take off. Luis Jacobo. Hayden James, son of Brandy Beeler and Jonathan James. Hayden has been active in FFA throughout his high school career, and he plans to continue to work on the family farm and join the local workforce through a union apprenticeship after receiving his diploma today. Hayden James. Edgar Jimenez, son of Bertha Gomez Jimenez and Efren Jimenez. Edgar has been active in the theater and fine arts during his time at Bremen High School, and he is planning to major in business at Indiana University in South Bend. Edgar Jimenez. Giselle Jimenez, daughter of Maria Jimenez and Jamie Bees. Giselle has been active in various clubs and sports throughout high school, and she plans to pursue a degree in chemistry at St. Mary's College while working as a certified emergency medical technician. Giselle Jimenez. Jonathan Jimenez, son of Maria Gonzalez and Hector Jimenez. When asked about his future plans, Jonathan said he is still undecided about his future. For now, he hopes to find a job in our community. Jonathan Jimenez. Sergio Jimenez, son of Hilda and Juan Jimenez. Sergio has enlisted in the United States Air Force and performing electrical maintenance on planes. Sergio Jimenez. Dylan Kent, son of Karen and Tony Gilly and Brandy and Pavo Kent. Dylan also has enlisted in the United States Air Force, and he plans to be part of the military pararescue team. Dylan Kent. Kristen Curte, daughter of Tracy and Sean Curte. Kristen, a co-captain of the Color Guard and Winter Guard, and the senior artist of the year at Bremen High School, will be studying art at Indiana University in South Bend next year with hopes of going to California to be a freelance artist. Kristen Curte. Ashton Cusera, son of Mandy and Brian Cusera, a talented brass player in the band. Ashton plans to attend Indiana University in South Bend to pursue a career in business or electronic music. Ashton Cusera. Julianne Lawmaster, daughter of Sherry and Jay Lawmaster, an outstanding woodwind player in the band. Julianne was also the drum major during the marching band season. Julianne plans to go to Purdue, but she also plans to travel the world. Julianne Lawmaster. Haley Learman, daughter of Melissa and Bradley Learman. Haley, a co-captain of the Color Guard and Winter Guard, and an active participant in the drama productions at Bremen High School, will be studying at Indiana University in South Bend to become an elementary school teacher. Haley Learman. Erica Berry, daughter of Kimberly and Robert Winter. Erica will be studying child psychology at Indiana University in South Bend. Erica Berry. Mackenzie Meister, daughter of Christy and Kurt Meister. Kenzie is the student council president, and she is the MVP of the cheerleading team in 2020. Kenzie has already earned a training certificate at the Elkhart Career Center in nursing, and she will be attending Indiana University in South Bend to pursue a career in medical imaging. Kenzie Meister. Zachary Miller, son of Sherry and Matt Cowper. Zach plans to receive training from a local plumbers and pipe fitters union to earn a job in the heating and air conditioning business. Zachary Miller. Briley Murphy, daughter of Judy and the late James Murphy. Briley has been involved in the fall drama productions each year, and she is pursuing a teaching career by attending Indiana University at South Bend. Briley Murphy. McKenna Myers, daughter of Kim and Michael Myers and Andrew Pinter. A gifted musical performer and an academic all-state athlete, McKenna is committed to play softball at St. Mary's College while pursuing a biology major and business management minor, with career plans of becoming a mortician. McKenna Myers. Caitlin Nickerson, daughter of Heather Walaski and Keith Nickerson. Caitlin is pursuing her dream of becoming a dental hygienist by attending Indiana University in South Bend. Caitlin Nickerson. Sydney Nichol, daughter of Charity and Ron Nichol. Sydney is pursuing a career in the dental assisting profession by attending a dental assisting school in South Bend. Sydney Nichol. Nathan Olivares, son of Beatriz Regosa and Damon Olivares. Nathan has enlisted in the United States Army. He said he likes the thought of doing something better and bigger than himself. Nathan Olivares. Taylor Perez, son of Sonia Lopez and Salvador Perez Lopez. Taylor will be attending the University of Northwestern of Ohio and majoring in auto and diesel mechanics. He's also interested in pursuing a career in the military. Taylor Perez. Lillian Reed, daughter of Emily and Eric Reed. Lillian wants to become a marine biologist, and she will be starting her post-secondary education at Indiana University in South Bend with hopes of transferring to Hawaii. Lillian Reed. Shelby Ritter, daughter of Lindsay and Chad Ritter. Shelby has already spent 2 years during her high school career studying criminal justice at the Elkhart Career Center, and she's now planning to pursue a college degree in criminal justice at Indiana University in South Bend. Shelby Ritter. Jamie Sandoval, son of Adriana Hiltron and Jamie Sandoval. Jamie has enlisted in the Indiana National Guard, and he hopes to work and further his education to do some type of engineering that's useful for the environment. Jamie Sandoval. Jennifer Santillan, daughter of Consuelo and Idafonso Santillan. Jennifer was a 4-year letter winner in soccer. She plans to continue working at the Bremen Boys and Girls Club while attending Indiana University in South Bend to become a nurse. Jennifer Santillan. Isaiah Sorrell, son of Katisha Dixon and grandson of Kit and Mike Mishler. Simply stated, Isaiah simply makes everyone smile. And I'm sure he plans to continue that habit as he pursues his plan to work at Woody's Supermarket. I'm going to miss that big guy at school. Isaiah Cyril. Justin Schmidt, son of Beth and Scott Schmidt. Active in jazz band, marching band, and swimming, Justin is pursuing certification as a paramedic and firefighter through Ivy Tech. Justin Schmidt. Brandon Schmucker, son of Margaret and Aaron Schmucker. Active as a percussionist in the Bremen High School band. Brandon has enlisted in the National Guard, and he is pursuing a degree in music at Purdue Fort Wayne. Brandon Schmucker. Justin Schrom, son of Stephanie and Brian Schrom. Justin plans to continue working the job he enjoys in the RV paint industry. However, he also said he would like to get a warmer weather state someday and move south. Justin Schrom. Bradley Seifer, son of Heather Seifer, Tom Owsley, and John and Chris Seifer. Brad earned his diploma after attending Bremen High School for only 3 years, and he has been working the past year as a diesel mechanic, and he plans to continue diesel mechanic work. Bradley Seifer. Jonathan Shoemaker, son of Brenda Eppel and Tony Shoemaker. Jonathan plans to attend Ivy Tech to become an emergency medical technician and firefighter. In fact, he arrived to commencement today in a fire truck. Jonathan Shoemaker. Kaylee Simmons, daughter of Sherry and Chris Simmons. MVP of both the golf team and the swim team. Kaylee is committed to be on the swim team at Bethel University while she studies psychology and criminal justice. Kaylee Simmons. Robert Simons, son of Jane and Ron Simons. Bobby enjoys acting, singing, running, and English classes. He earned the highest honors in his dual credit English courses, and he is planning to major in English at Indiana University at South Bend. Robert Simons. Samantha Sloss, daughter of Amber Kunder and David Sloss Jr. Samantha is planning to attend college online through Western Governors University with a focus on health administration and business management. Samantha Sloss. Emily Smith, daughter of Darlene Smith and Todd Smith. Emily is a 4-year letter winner in both soccer and tennis, and she is planning to major in biomedical engineering at Indiana University with hopes of becoming a physician's assistant. Emily Smith. Lily Snyder, daughter of Jill and Ted Snyder. Treasurer of the senior class, Lily is pursuing a psychology degree at Purdue University. Lily Snyder. Megan Starr, daughter of Lydia Marks and James Starr. Megan has been involved in cheerleading during her years at Bremen High School, and she plans to have a career in custom painting. Megan Starr. Joshua Spakowski, son of Melissa Heiss and the late Joseph Spakowski Sr. Selected as the most outstanding brass player in the band and captain of the fine arts academic team, Josh is attending Ball State University with hopes of becoming a band teacher. Joshua Spakowski. Janitzi Valderrama, daughter of Elvia and Efren Valderrama. Active in both the art club and on the soccer team, Janitzi is planning to attend Indiana University with an undecided major. Janitzi Valderrama. Gabriella Valencia, daughter of Sherry Valencia. Gabriella currently has a full-time job in the food service industry, and she is planning to pursue training to become a veterinary assistant. Gabriella Valencia. Megan Wagers, daughter of Jeremy Wagers and Nicole Criffield. When asked about her future plans, Megan said that she is researching a career path in the field of interior design. Megan Wagers. Becca Walter, daughter of Nicole and Jordan Walter. Becca plans to attend a trade school to become a dental assistant or dental hygienist. Becca Walter. Summer Walters, daughter of Aurora and Joe Walters. Co-captain of the cheerleading squad, Summer plans to first become a paralegal and eventually a lawyer. She will be attending Eastern Florida State College, Summer Walters. Catherine Whitaker, daughter of Nancy and Mark Whitaker. Catherine has participated in the theater and music programs at Bremen High School in addition to running track. She plans to attend Olivet Nazarene University with an undecided major. Catherine Whitaker. Reese Willis, son of Heidi and John Willis, captain of the basketball team and recipient of the U.S. Marine Corps Distinguished Athlete Award, Reese is committed to play baseball at Goshen College while majoring in business. Reese Willis. Bryce Waugaman, son of Jessica and Brian Waugaman, co-captain of the football team. Bryce plans to major in biochemistry at Indiana University in hopes of pursuing a career in dentistry. Bryce Waugaman. Evan Yoder, son of Carmen and Glenn Yoder, active in multiple sports and music productions. Evan is the recipient of the U.S. Army Reserve National Scholar Athlete Award. He will be attending Indiana University in South Bend, majoring in computer science. Evan Yoder. Shauna York, daughter of Samantha and Lucky Ellsworth and the late Tony York, the senior that sang our national anthem today. Shauna has been involved in various musical performances. She will be attending Indiana University in South Bend with a double major in music and special education. Shauna York. Aaron Young, son of Angela and Jim Young. An MVP long distance runner at Bremen High School, Aaron has an undecided college major, but he will be attending Indiana University in South Bend in the fall. He plans to become also a volunteer firefighter. Aaron Young. Seth Young, son of Brooke Solis and Nick Young, a member of the show choir and track and cross country teams. Seth is planning to major in psychology at Indiana University in South Bend. Seth Young. Noah Youngman, son of Patty and TJ Youngman. Noah is the secretary of the Bremen High School FFA, and he is planning to attend Ivy Tech to become a paramedic and firefighter. Noah Youngman. Kyle Zimmer, son of Lisa Wood Zimmer. MVP in show choir, BTV broadcasting, and the school newspaper production. Kyle plans to attend Indiana University to pursue a license to teach English as a second language in foreign countries. He also may be pursuing a job in the entertainment business. Kyle Zimmer.
I have more of a face for radio anyway than live streaming, so I probably broke a few computers there. All right, attention all members of the class, the Supreme Class of 2020. Please, at this point in time, use your right hand to move the tassel of your cap from the right side to the left side. And by the powers vested in me by the state of Indiana and the Board of School Trustees, I now pronounce you graduates of Bremen High School. On behalf of the whole town of Bremen and beyond, I offer you our sincere congratulations. Excellent work, people.
Ceremony is over. Dr. White, gotta have you on one more time.
Well, we got no choice.
Official.
All the girls and boys. Making all.
I have more of a face for radio anyway than live streaming, so I probably broke a few computers there.
All right, attention, all members of the class, the Supreme Class of 2020. Please, at this point in time, use your right hand to move the tassel of your cap from the right side to the left side. And by the powers vested in me by the state of Indiana and the Board of School Trustees, I now pronounce you graduates of Bremen High School. On behalf of the whole town of Bremen and beyond, I offer you our sincere congratulations. Excellent work, people.